What's going on, moviegoers? If you're new to the channel, my name is Christian. Welcome to SeaWorld Productions, you guys. They dropped a bunch of brand new clips for Spider-Man No Way Home that I have yet to see. I cannot wait to react to it, you guys. We are almost there. We are almost less than a week away, you guys, and we get to watch the highly most anticipated movie of the year for Spider-Man No Way Home, you guys. The excitement level is out the roof. I am so freaking pumped. But also, we got a brand new image, too, that was really interesting, but not surprising. The Green Goblin's helmet on the floor, destroyed. Now, I remember Tom Holland said that there's a bloody fight between him and the Green Goblin, which I cannot wait to watch. The Green Goblin is the main villain of the movie, despite having other villains as well, that being Doc Ock, Electro, Sandman, and the Lizard. But it's personal, confirmed by William Dafoe himself. It's personal for the Green Goblin. I am just curious to know why it's personal for the Green Goblin and how him being stripped from his particular timeline in Spider-Man, how it's going to cause a ripple effect of different events to occur. And I want to know why it's personal for him. You guys, I am so freaking excited. I cannot wait to see the whole fight between Spider-Man and Green Goblin. I'm really hoping like it's something, you know, from the first film, because Tom Holland said that was one of his favorite moments, you know, in Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man universe. He said he loves, you know, the ripped suits, and I do too. I always feel like, you know, the MCU Spider-Man not having the ripped suit, it takes away from the actual real-life damage that Spider-Man would obtain when fighting some of these villains, man. I cannot wait, you guys. Let's dive deep into some of these reactions. I am hyped. Let's get into it. I think I got maybe like 5 different reactions. All right, you guys ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, shit. Jumped after him? Finally, some cool web swinging.
When we get into MIT, we should live together.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I love that.
This is going to be us.
Yes. Mine is the Frisbee.
Preparing for the new trilogy.
A new town. I can Spider-Man there. I mean, they have crime in Boston, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, wicked crime.
Yeah, so it'll be like a fresh start. We'll all be together.
Finally, college.
Fresh start.
Hello, Peter.
Why
have you done with my machine?
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what machine.
Oh, it's music.
Cash.
Oh, shit. Oh, hell yeah. Then the train comes.
Ready? Nice knowing you, Spider-Man.
Wait, excuse me?
The entire world's about to forget that Peter Parker is Spider-Man.
Everyone, can't some people still know?
That's not how the spell works.
So my girlfriend's just gonna forget about everything we've been through? I mean, is she even gonna be my girlfriend?
All right, fine. Everyone in the world's gonna forget that you're Spider-Man, except your girlfriend.
Thank you so much. Oh my God, Ned.
Okay, let's not change the parameters of this spell anymore. Wow, I'm
okay, I'm done. I swear I'm done.
Oh, shit. Oh, man. And that is how the multiverse starts. So they say. Does it start with Wanda being a Nexus being? Or does it start with Loki and Kang? You guys, I am so fucking excited for this movie. That beginning clip must take place literally at the beginning of this movie, where it left off from Spider-Man Far From Home with this whole identity reveal. That's exciting stuff. Really curious to see how they're going to go upon that, with everybody knowing that Peter Parker is Spider-Man. Everybody he loves is going to have a target on their back. Aunt May's going to die, and I'm calling it right now, and I'm not ready for it. I'm going to cry my eyes out. Not Aunt May. Not Aunt May. And then, of course, the fight scene with him and Doc Ock on the bridge. Cannot wait to see that and how it expands, because in the trailer, Green Goblin actually shows up. Even more exciting. Oh, man, that's just so dope. I love how they threw in the, you know, Doc Ock's original music from Spider-Man 2 in there. Love that. Love that, dude. Oh, I cannot wait. That scene looks so freaking awesome, man. I can't wait to see Doc Ock and Spider-Man fight. I can't wait to see Doc Ock potentially fight Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man again. That is going to be a banger, you guys. A huge freaking banger. Oh, my God. And then, of course, the final scene of him botching that entire spell. And Doctor Strange. Come on, Doctor Strange. You would think that being the Sorcerer Supreme, he can take anything, especially a teenager talking to him, and he can't focus on the spell. He's like, okay, your girlfriend won't know. Okay. Ned, no. Oh, she's be quiet. You would think, like, being the Sorcerer Supreme, you'd be able, you know, to kind of control that. But apparently, you know, that spell is dangerous. And Wong did warn him, Steven, don't even think about doing that spell. Nah, I won't. But then there's that big question of, is that Doctor Strange? Is it? Could that be evil Doctor Strange? We don't know, because we all know he's acting kind of sus in these trailers, you guys. I guess we'll all find out by next weekend, whatever that post-credit scene, which will most likely lead into Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. Cannot wait. Post your comments down below. Let me know what you guys thought about these clips from Spider-Man No Way Home. And have you gotten your tickets yet? And if you haven't, what are you waiting for? Come on now. Post your comments down below. Peace.